orders. Staying on top of your orders is a necessary habit of successful trading. In this video, I'll walk you through the orders widget in Robinhood Legend, our brand new browser-based trading platform. You'll learn how to review, filter, and customize your layout, and most importantly, how to manage your orders effectively. Let's get started. All right, I'm staring at a blank layout in Robinhood Legend. I've named this layout Recent Orders. And the first thing we're gonna do is click Add Widget, and we're gonna add recent orders to our layout. Now, the first thing you wanna do is kinda get familiar with the layout of this widget. Starting in the upper left-hand corner, we have our linking square. So if we had other widgets on the platform, we can link the orders widget to those. To the right of that, we have a search functionality. This is where if we wanna filter by a specific stock within our list of orders, maybe you have a very large list of orders and you wanna quickly find one. In this example, I'm just gonna select Walmart because I know I have an order in the account. We can hit enter on our keyboard or select it from the dropdown. And now you see the Walmart order in our account, which is a canceled order to buy 10 shares at a limit price of 50. Now the only order being displayed on our screen. If we want to remove that filter, click the X, and now we're back to the entire list of our recent orders. Over here on the right, we have another button. This is the button to filter. So just as we filtered by a specific symbol through the search functionality, we can do even more filtering by clicking this button. And you'll see we can filter both by asset type. So if you have equities orders, options orders, and you want to filter by those, or if you just want to see all listed, you can keep it as all. So for example, let's click on equities, and now you can see our list has minimized to just the orders having to do with stock or ETFs. If I click on options, I'm going to filter this by any orders and recent orders that have to do with an options position. Let's go back to all. Now you can also, in addition to asset type, filter by order type. So maybe you're looking for orders that are market orders. You wanna address those, and you can see here, this is a filled market order from earlier in the day. We can see our limit orders, a stop market. So that's one way to filter, is by the order type. You can combine these two. So maybe we wanna see all equity orders that are limit orders. And now you can see we've limited to just those two filter criteria. If we wanna go back to the default state, we're just gonna click clear, and now we're back to all asset types, all order types listed in our recent orders widget. All right, to the right of that, we have the three-dot settings menu. This is where, as with other widgets in Robinhood Legend, we are gonna customize our columns or delete the widget. Now with recent orders, there's a lot of data that we can add to this. So the first thing that I would recommend to everyone out there is figure out which data points are important to you. You may not need all of these. So if you're trying to keep your screen clean, as well as to be able to quickly scan the information that is important to you, you know, figure out which data points are important to you and add them, and remove the ones that aren't. As with other widgets in Legend, if we want to add new data points, we'll just click the check mark to add those. If we want to remove something, we will uncheck them. And we can do this until we've found the specific set of data that we are concerned with. Once you've selected the data points that you want to see visible, we can resize, resort, and basically move around things based on our preferences. So the first thing we can do is we can sort columns. So you notice right now by default, everything is sorted by the status of the order. So you see working, filled, canceled. If we wanted to flip that, we would click the column header, and now we're sorting by canceled, filled, working. Personally, I like to see my working orders at the top of my screen because those are the orders that are working in the market and may become positions. Filled orders, canceled orders, those are in the past. There's nothing we can do about those. But working orders, maybe you want to keep that at the top of your screen. Totally up to you. If you want to do a quick sort by symbol, we can do that as well. So if we want to list these by alphabetical order or reverse alphabetical order, we can do this by the time you submitted the order. And maybe I need to find that order that I placed recently, but I know it was sometime a certain date and time. This allows you to quickly scan those orders based on the time submitted. I'm gonna go back to sorting these by status. Now the next we can do is we can resize a column. As with any column that you see in Robinhood Legend, we can grab the edge of it and we can move it left and right. Maybe we wanna see more or less information within that column. But the other tip that I wanna give you is, just like an Excel spreadsheet, if you just wanna snap these columns to the size that they need to be to make all of the data visible, just hover your mouse over the edge and double click, and it's gonna extend it out just like you would in an Excel spreadsheet. All right, the next thing we show you to do is maybe you wanna reformat or reorder the columns. Maybe you want something on the front of your list, something in the back. It's easy to do. Just grab the column header with your mouse and move it over to the position that you wanna see. So maybe we want our order, time, and submission at the front of our list. And there it is. We've now put it right there on the left-hand side. We wanna move it back, same thing. Grab it with your mouse, put it in the position that you prefer. Now, the other way you can sort your columns is going to the settings menu, go over customize columns. You can grab any of these with your mouse and drag them up and down the list. So if you have a long list of data and you don't want to scroll all the way and then drag it all the way back to the other side, you can just move it in this menu by clicking and dragging up and down. All right, so I've gone ahead and I've added some more data points. One thing you'll notice when you do that, if the data extends off your screen, maybe you have other widgets around this and you have limited screen space, you'll notice two things. One, your symbol column on the left, that's a frozen column. You really can't move that. So in that sense, that is a static column. Meanwhile, if we want to see the rest of the data to the right that is off screen, we just slide our mouse back and forth, left and right, and you'll see that scroll bar at the bottom move as we move our mouse. So this is one way where you can add extra data without resizing the widget, but still have access to that data. You'll also notice that as I move, that symbol column stays frozen and hovers over the rest of the data. So this is very much like a spreadsheet that you've frozen one of the columns and it allows you to go back and forth while still seeing which data is connected to which symbol. And the other nice thing from a design standpoint is as I move my mouse over each line of information, you'll see that the horizontal line is also shaded. So you can quickly, with just scanning across your screen, see which order details is relevant to which symbol. Okay, what we've done now, we've created an entire two monitor layout. On my left monitor, I've got the account summary widget, my watch list below that. Above at the top half portion of the screen is the recent orders widget that we've been working in this video. Below that, positions. And then over on my right monitor, it's an entire monitor dedicated to charts. Now, the first thing I did was I linked all of these widgets together using the linking tool. So you'll notice in the upper left-hand corner of every widget is this blue square. So what that means, if I were to go through my watch list and start selecting a stock, all of these widgets are going to update based on the stock I've selected from my watch list. So here I've clicked on Apple. You'll notice that our recent orders widget says we don't have any Apple orders for the last 24 hours. Meanwhile, we do have a couple of Apple positions, so those are showing. And then on the right-hand side, we have the Apple chart. Now, one tip, and this is really a personal preference type of thing, but if you want to scroll through your watch list, update data across different widgets, but keep your recent orders visible, it's as simple as unlinking the widget from the rest. So you can do that by clicking the upper left-hand corner in the linking group square, select unlinked. We'll get rid of that filter for Apple. And now you can see all of our orders are back invisible in the widget. And as I scroll through the watch list, you'll notice the different widgets, positions, and chart are updating, but recent orders is staying static. So personally, what I like about this is, once again, your working orders, your recent orders, those are things you may want to keep an eye on at all times. In this case, we have four working orders in the account, one filled and two canceled. We may always want to keep an eye on those in case any of those are getting close to being filled. And so this allows us to navigate through that watch list while still keeping that data visible. All right, last but not least, let's do some trading from the recent orders widget. If you think about it, you know, there's going to be times where you need to go into these working orders and cancel, replace, change the price. You can do that straight from the widget. So the first thing you'll notice as I hover my mouse over any order in this list, you're going to see some buttons on the right-hand side of the screen start to display. But depending on what order you have, you're going to get the option to either straight out cancel that order, which means we're going to cancel it, get rid of it from working in the market, or you can replace an order. So let's do the cancel first. Right now we have four working orders in this account. Let's just pick this Nike order. We have a working order to buy 25 shares on a limit price. That limit is good till canceled. So this technically, this orders would be working until we cancel it or 90 days after we placed it. If we just wanted to straight up get rid of this order, it's as simple as clicking cancel. And you can notice in the upper right-hand corner, we have the notification that order to buy 25 shares of Nike was canceled. And now, instead of being status working, that Nike order has a status of canceled. Now, what if you wanted to keep the order working, but just replace it? Maybe you want to change the price, the order type, the time and force. Let's look at this order for, we've got an order for Amazon working to sell one share at a limit price of $225, good till canceled. Let's change the price. Let's change that from 225 to, let's just pick a random number, 230. I'm gonna hit replace, and that's gonna queue up the order ticket right below this menu. You see we have Amazon. The order is already queued up to sell. Limit price of one at 225, good till canceled. So what it has done, it has pre-populated our existing order into the order ticket. And now it's just up to us to make those changes. We said we wanted to change this price from 225 to 230. And do that, click my mouse out of that box. And now we have the order queued up and ready to go. And we'll hit replace order. And there you see, we've got both fills that one, our original order was canceled and the new order is working. If we confirm with our list, you can see the new Amazon working order to sell one at 230 is working. Meanwhile, if we go to canceled, there's that original order, Amazon canceled, sell one at a limit price of 225. So very quick and easy to maneuver through your working orders, filter, organize, and see what's happening in your account at all times. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe for more tips and tutorials on Robinhood Legend. Have a question? Drop it below in the comments. We'd love to hear from you. Happy trading. I'll see you in the next video.